Ladies and gentlemen, hello.
Hello.
Welcome to $2 Broom. What this world needs, according to the great musician Captain Beefheart, is a good $2 room and a good $2 broom. We're supplying the latter. Definitely hit.
Our next piece is called the Arpeggioni Sonata.
and it features the React table.
Thank you.
asked, maybe I should explain what's going on here. So this is an improvisation group. Everything we do is electroacoustic, meaning we have actual acoustic instruments playing through electronic processing and instruments that are sort of processors or synthesizers themselves. And within the framework of that, we're making it up as we go along. So for the students in the band and for myself, it's been a great exercise in exploring very different sound worlds from what we're used to and for being extremely creative about the material that we play, learning how to make it as interesting as possible, learning how to sense when the right time to play is and when the right time to shut up is, what kind of sound we want when, and we have practically infinite, we really do have infinite sounds because we have thousands of sounds to play with and every one of them is infinitely adjustable. So it's a work in progress. I think everybody's learned an amazing amount of stuff by doing this experimentation, and we're going to keep going in years to come. So what we're going to do, we're going to continue with kind of featuring instruments, and then we're going to have some other kinds of improvisatory games we're going to play and let you go after that. So next we're going to feature this complete keyboard, which is it's a MIDI keyboard that interfaces with the computer, so it gets all of its sounds from the computer and has about 3,000 sounds as a starting point, and then we can alter those as we go. So are you ready?
Yes. I don't know what sound I picked.
Song is called Blonde on Top.
Thank you.
synthesizer. This is one of the two very old instruments in the club. I mean, it's a brand new instrument, but the Moog synthesizer has been around since around the 1950s. And while it's acquired more bells and whistles, it's still an analog synthesizer like from the old days. So we're going to feature this instrument next.
Thank you. Thank you.